My name is Franciska De Jong. I'm the executive director of CLARIN Eric. And this is a workshop that takes place in the context of a European project that is run by CLARIN Eric and a few other institutes in the community that can be labeled CLARIN. And that project is called CLARIN Plus. As I suppose that many of you, I suppose that many of you are familiar with CLARIN, but some of you may not have attended presentations on CLARIN or have been able to ask questions. So I think it would be good to try to summarize the quintessence of CLARIN. So here I have a short summary in four bullets. Good afternoon. CLARIN stands for Common Language Resources and Technology Infrastructure. And it is a kind of infrastructure, a research infrastructure, that provides easy and sustainable access for scholars in the humanities and the social sciences and beyond. We could discuss this list of disciplines and the potential extension later on. It gives access to digital language data in all formats, written, spoken, video, combinations, so multimodality is also an issue. It gives access to language data, and in addition, it gives access to advanced tools to discover, explore, annotate, analyze, and combine those data wherever they are located and for the various purposes that scholars need to be supported in during their work. So this is a very general story, which is more or less in place since some 5 years when CLARIN started with to be active as a consortium of 9 countries. Currently, we are 19. On this map, you see only 17 because very recently we could welcome Hungary and Latvia as number 18 and number 19. So we're growing and getting stronger. And CLARIN Plus is a project that will help us to strengthen our position and to become better prepared for the stages to come and to build a sustainable infrastructure. As I said, CLARIN is an infrastructure, a research infrastructure that helps scholars and scientists in their work that is making use of language data. So in a way, you could position CLARIN in the domain of data science, because language is a data type. So you could say that CLARIN is providing analytics for text and speech data as a pillar for data science. And if you consider that a bit longer, it means that CLARIN has the potential to contribute to the development of new methodological frameworks, because data science is, on the one hand, it's a hype, it's a buzzword that can mean anything that you need for the kind of message that you want to bring across. But if you really take it seriously and try to ignore the buzziness of it, data science, without taking into account the contribution of textual data, is incomplete. And that means that in developing data science, we need to contribute to the development of new methodological frameworks. And those frameworks should aim at the integration or the integrated processing of multiple data types. And thus also for it plays a role in the development of a multidisciplinary research agenda or multiple agendas. Another angle in the mission or pillar in the mission of CLARIN is given in by the fact that language, specifically in Europe, comes in many flavors. So multilinguality is a basis for what we are doing, but seen from the angle of data science, you could see that you could say that because of the multilinguality and the fact that multilinguality links the data type to various regions and countries, CLARIN has the potential to support comparative research of all kinds of societal phenomena, and in particular, of course, those that that are reflected in language use, which means that we could contribute to the study of migration patterns, the study of intellectual history, the study of language variation, and that list can be made much longer. So CLARIN is working on text and speech as data, or more precisely, CLARIN is working towards the support of a research that takes text and speech as social and cultural data. From this mission, you can easily infer that there are various textual data types, language data types, that are of interest to this mission and to the community of users, HIPO, that we want to serve. So here I give a list of data types that is diverse and not complete, but it is good to be aware of the diversity of data types and the research agendas connected to it if you want to discuss the mission of CLARIN. So I suppose it's easily readable, but the dots indicate the things that are not in there, but clearly newspaper archives fit into this list.